be showing my top 10 of my probably favourite Lego figures of all time. This will only be from probably about 2014 to 2015, and probably my personal favourites. So, here we go! First of all, is getting to okay. This is a Wookiee from a starship I brought in a microfighter set. It's about $8.99. It's not much, but it just comes with a miniature starship from, I think it's from the new Star Wars Rebels. And yeah, it does come with a crossbow, and sometimes I do pretend that it is actual Chewbacca with just without his sort of gun bar there. And the second one, that was my first favourite because it's really good and really useful. My second favourite would be my a bit custom Hawkeye. Okay, so the only bit I did change about him is that his head, as you can see, is a bit different to other people and the actual original Hawkeye that you can get in the Age of Ultron set. So you can buy now, but they're going to be out of stock really soon because a lot of people buy them. And so I changed his head. He doesn't have an additional head behind it, but it does look a bit more serious, and the eyebrows are the same color this time. So why did I say carrot then? And so yeah, that's the only thing different about it. I think I did change his black hand to the other side. I don't know why. I think that's just when I messed up all my characters. Okay, number three would be my Drax the Destroyer from Guardians of the Galaxy. He's completely double-sided head. He's got a bunch of really new printing. See, so he's got like red sort of Lego skulls, and he does wear the Guardians of the Galaxy uniform underneath, like as his trousers. And it does come with knives, but I sometimes use group finger. I don't really know why. It's the only thing I had left. But yeah, he has printing also on his arm, which is really useful, and on the back of his head, and his back has also got a massive red skull. Okay, fourth favourite of mine would be the First Order Stormtrooper. This is from the new Star Wars Force Awakens. It's a bit like the new ones, and it comes with like a gun, and if you put a stub piece in this area here, I'm pointing to my finger, if you flick that down, it does shoot out. I might show you right now, okay? Really, really fiddly to put in.
Don't worry, mate, you can crop things out.
Yeah, Mum, we're fine!
I can crop it out.
Okay, so as you can see, I've put a red original thing that actually came with it, and it has a lot of printing, not like the other Stormtrooper with a lot of armor, but does have new a belt and printing on his legs. If you take off his helmet, there's not much there, but I changed it to a double-sided. I think I got this from Legolas the elf. Now he's a bit of a, you know, grumpy face there, but if you turn it around, it's more angrily and serious. And so yeah, I did change his head because the first one was more angry, you know, a bit boring. Okay, where am I? My fifth. I remembered. Thank you, Megan. I've got my Miles Morales from the new Ultimate Spider-Man Lego sets. This comes with Carnage, another villain character. It's Carnage is a bit like Venom, but he has red basically instead. He has a lot like printing, a bit like Drax, but sort of like the opposite direction. this is basically like Spider-Man's suit, except from on the back, it's got sort of a dangling spider from the back. And he does wear red and black, which is quite one of the obvious things. And he has sort of shading, I think, in his eyes to make it look more realistic. So yeah, that's basically the same. I think his real name in Marvel Comics is Miles Morales. I don't know how you actually pronounce it, but that's what it said. Okay, then. Right. Sixth one is my Batman. This Batman is probably my second Batman. I do have the painted black boot one, which I don't have at the moment, but it will, basically I will find it soon. And so yeah, basically he does have another, he has just that angry face there, probably a bit serious fighting the Joker. And he comes with a serious sort of, I don't know, unhappy, grumpy face. He has new printing, which you can also get this Batman, but with a different helmet, on the Lego Dimensions pack, I think, starter pack. And it comes with a new fabric cape, which is a lot more softer. And you can, it's more flexible, really. And the helmet is much different from the others, to the other Batmans from the very start. And it doesn't have the chin piece right here. And it is a lot different to the others, which is quite good. And it, in the actual headpiece, it comes with like a black bit there. And it's a lot more tanned. I think he got a very bad tan for this. Okay then, I think we're on my seventh now. My seventh is Thor from the new Age of Ultron Lego sets. Basically, as you can see through the camera, he does have a bit of a ginger beard. I wish they made like a different coloured hair, or at least make like his beard a bit more like his hair. But that's what all the other Thors are like, basically. His hammer's always stayed the same. He does have an additional angry face. And yes, a lot like every other minifigures. And so yeah, and he does have the fabric cape like the new Batman does, not so stiff like the last ones, which is really useful. I do use this for a lot of animations, and it's much better than the last one that you can get. And it's got much better printing, like, on his chest. And I wish they would have made, like, armor printing, like, it looks a bit like scales, maybe on the side of his arms, but Lego has its limits. Okay, eighth one. I can see I'm surprised by this, is Green Lantern. From the Sinestro battle set, I believe. It comes with Space Batman. I don't think I have that anymore. But yeah. And then basically, I've seen a lot of Green Lanterns, and in my opinion, this is probably the best one, according to the comics. And it's probably like the very first issue of like when Green Lantern first came out. He has hair, just like a normal messed up hair. And he has an additional head. This one's a more serious looking head, obviously when he's battling people. And he does have the Green Lantern sign on his chest there. And very, very, very good printing on his legs. And I wish they would have made a special piece that actually came with his, like maybe his ring. That'd be really useful. Anyways, sorry about that bunny. There's my pet. Sorry, this is just hello, guys. Anyways, sorry. Anyways, so my, what's this about, 9th favourite character, we're almost at our last now, second to last, is the Man of Steel Superman. They have put some like metal printing on his legs, just a bit there. I don't have his laser vision head at the moment, and I can see you, Megan, that's very annoying, you know. Hello there. And he does come with the original.
I'm hiding the potato!
Yeah, he comes with the normal average hair for Superman, with sort of like a curl near his head. And also, as I don't have the laser vision head, which is basically an angry head, but it's a bit like Hyperion. And so, he does have printing all over there, and I wish they would have made it maybe like, made it like with red boots, like they do on the new Batman vs Superman sets. And this also comes with the fabric cape, just like four. They're exactly the same, actually. And this is my very last character. Okay. My 10th favourite, I think, was the Joker. It's basically like the last one, except it has more, instead of a yellow jacket, checkered jacket underneath, he has a blue one. Yeah, he does. And this time I gave him a remote, so like he can control stuff or a detonating bomb. And he just has a smiley grinning face like the normal average Joker. And got the very first ones. Okay, so, it's very hard to see, it's like the opposite of the camera. Anyways, okay, so the next face is sort of like a smirk, and I think a new thing, I think it's new, is that he has a bow this time, and it's a green bow, and the last one was a dark green sort of tie. Okay then. That is all my top 10 favourite characters. Thanks for watching. Please put a comment down underneath. And remember, this is my first video, so I won't be a professional. And being a YouTuber is a really great opportunity to me to show you guys what I think. Okay, so please subscribe if you can. And
subscribe!
Goodbye! See you later.
I am the camera woman.